Hello and welcome to the series on Fsharp, where we're going over key concepts to help you get started build your own Fsharp applications. In this video, we're going to be going over values, how to associate these values with descriptive names, and how to transform these values or apply changes to them. Now, I could probably explain these things to you, but it's probably easier if I just show you with code. Any code that you see in this video can be found at aka.ms/fsharp-101-samples. Now let's take a look at some code. In this example, I have a script called values.fsx. Values are pieces of data. Although this is not an exhaustive list, you can see that there are different types of values such as strings to represent text, booleans to represent true or false, integers to represent numbers, tuples, which provide a way to group values, lists, which hold collections of values, and lambda expressions or anonymous functions, which are ways of applying transformations to values. Let's take a look at what these values look like when we evaluate them. Although values represent pieces of data, on their own, they don't mean much. However, binding them or associating them with a descriptive name gives values more meaning and it makes them easier to share throughout your application. To bind values in Fsharp, you use the let keyword. We can see here that although these values are exactly the same as those above, by binding them, we've given them more meaning. Now, New York is a city name. Fsharp is awesome, and that's true. Our lucky number is number 13. If we want to find our location on a map, maybe creating a tuple with coordinates would be helpful. Now, we have a to-do list here, which is telling us to learn Fsharp, and hopefully, after this, you'll build an app and maybe profit. Or maybe you want to create a name function here, which takes an input and divides it by 3. Whatever the type may be, as you can see, adding a name definitely adds meaning and context to your values. Let's take a look at what these bound values look like when we evaluate them. Now, there's a few things that I'd like to point out. Notice how there are these annotations next to the values. These annotations are provided by the INITE extension and correspond to the value's type. In the case of lucky number, it's an integer. However, you'll notice that we haven't specified types anywhere. That's because of Fsharp's type inference. As the name suggests, type inference means that you do not have to explicitly provide your value types. Based on the information provided, the compiler can deduce or make a good guess of what the types are. As a result, you get to write less code, but you know that you have the power of the compiler checking the correctness of your program the entire way. Now, if the compiler doesn't have enough information, that's the only time you have to explicitly provide type annotations. And here's an example of how you do that. You provide the name of your value, followed by a colon, followed by the type. Let's see what this looks like when we evaluate it. Sometimes, you like to be able to change data. However, data in Fsharp is immutable by default. What this means is that values cannot be changed throughout the course of a program's execution. Therefore, trying to bind a new value to an existing name results in an error. The way you update values in Fsharp is by applying transformations to your data and binding the transform value to a new name. While this may seem like extra work at first, immutability actually provides a few benefits. From a compiler standpoint, immutability enables compilers to check code more stringently, which helps provide features like type inference. Immutability makes your code predictable. Because you don't have to worry about your original data changing, you only have to focus on the logic that applies transformations to your data locally. In turn, this also makes code easier to test and maintain. Let's take a look at what updating values looks like. As you can see, when we try to assign a new value to the existing city name, we get an error. However, if we make a transformation or a change to that data, and then we bind that to a new value or a new name, then in that case, there is no error. If you absolutely need to change data in place, you can do so by applying the mutable keyword. At that point, you should be able to use the assignment operator to change your data in place. Let's take a look at how that looks like. While sometimes mutability may be needed, I would highly recommend you to use immutable data as much as possible. Now that you know about value binding and immutability, in the next video, we're going to take a look at functions and how you can create reusable components of code that you can compose into even larger components, and then use these components to transform your data. See you then.